What's that? I do. What do I have? Oh, wait a minute. Oh, shit. Where's my friend from Australia? I have your bucket list. I thought I gave it to you, but I have your bucket list that I signed here. Good on you. Right now? Give it to me. Give it to me after this. So I met my wife 20 years ago. And what's funny is we were different people. We were different worlds. But I mean, we were the same person in so many ways, but we were so different. And it was a different time. And she was just going for her master's at St. John's University. And I was just a ball of crack fuckery. And there was a moment where my meeting her put a seismic shift in her life, right? Because it just wasn't like her to date some dude in a band. Now, and I want to, before I say anything, I want you to understand this was the 90s. So everything I'm about to say, there are certain references that I just get a pass because it was the 90s. So her and I, we fall in love immediately. Her father walks in the room, throws down a picture on the table. It's a New York Post and a picture of Scott Weiland, and he goes, "Is this him?" And her best friend, who is now my best friend, Dayon Cackle Stanisovic, he walked in the room and had an intervention with the entire family. Very serious, which is funny because Dayon's not serious. And he said, "Listen, we should talk. Madi is a groupie. Madi is dating a guy in a band. He wears eyeliner and nail polish." It was the 90s. And he brought it down. And so, all of those things aside, she still stuck with it. But we had a moment one night. I was in a hotel in Denver, Colorado, and she called me up and she had to let me know that this wasn't going to work. That as much as she loved me and she thought that we were all the things that we thought that we were, that the idea of my life and what I was doing and her being a part of it didn't make sense. And she hung up the phone, and that was kind of it for the night. And I kind of thought that I had just lost the greatest thing that I'd ever found. And so I wrote this song that night. So that's the story behind this. I think I've already lost you. I think you're already gone. Scared now, you think I'm weak, but I think you're wrong. Think you're already leaving. It feels like your hands are on the door. But I thought this place was an empire, and now I'm relaxed, and I can't be sure. But I think you're so mean. I think I can need this in my life, and I think I'm scared, but I think so much. I know it's wrong, it's a problem. I feel it if you're gone. Maybe it's time to come home. Cause there's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. And if you're gone, baby, you need to come home. Cause there's a little bit of something in me, in everything you. I'll bet you're hard to get over, and I'll bet my room just won't shine. Stay here, I bet you need more than you mind. But I think you're so mean, I think we should try. one I think I can be. This in my life, and I think I'm scared that I know too much. I can't relate, that's a problem I'm feeling. If you're gone, maybe it's time to come home. See, there's an awful lot of breathing room, but I can hardly move. And if you're gone, baby, you need to come home, come home. There's a little bit of something in me, in everything.
Thank you so much.